project kicked off probably in December when we got the RFP from Pride. They were looking for somebody to help them build the Pride in London 2018 app.
The fact that we're going for gold standard accessibility this year, that was a real focus for us, is to make sure that our app was as simple and easy to use as possible.
We know that we want to deliver an app that everybody can use. So it's extremely important to take special care at every part of the development process, such as screen readers need to be read clearly, and the icons need to be universally recognizable, as well as colours used, they have to be of high contrast.
Anyone with any visual impairments or just difficulty using digital devices could actually use the app, understand it, and plan their own Pride for themselves.
React Native allowed us to write our app with a familiar interface and a familiar API, but allowed us to build the kind of the native experiences that we really wanted to build for the application.
The Pride Labs was an opportunity to get everybody in the same room on a Saturday, rapidly ideate, have devs and designers pairing together, and also our Pride stakeholders could come along as well.
Having an event like a Pride Lab where we had different departments at Pride, some directors come and see the work we were doing, was a great catalyst to get people excited and involved, a great use of a day. Having sort of cross-functional teams work together on different problems. I really enjoyed it, and I'm sure everyone that came from Pride did as well.
Yeah, to make the project as open as possible, we did most of the stuff on open platforms. We hosted the project on a public Trello board, the code on public GitHub, communication on a public Slack channel.
Yeah, that we could invite anyone to join that was interested. We advertised the project in the communities that Red Badger were involved in as well, primarily the React community, which we host and are heavily involved in. We called for volunteers. There were a lot of enthusiastic volunteers and they've been involved since.
We took the approach of testing as and when is necessary, sometimes testing in around the office, and sometimes we go down on the street and test with people just out and about. And that gave us a really good sense of validating the things that we thought would work here in the office.
On the emotional side of things, we want them to feel delightful. We want the design to even surprise users along the way of discovering new events. Even going through lengths such as having micro interactions within the app. When you favorite an event, for example, you can see a little rainbow pass over the shape of the heart, and that itself, I hope, can surprise and delight the users. Yeah.
This project's meant a lot to me because I'm really passionate about the social value initiative that we set up about a year and a half ago, and this has actually just been like an amazing working proof of concept.
I've loved working with Red Badger. When I came in and met you guys, I could just feel the sort of energy and passion that Red Badger had for the project, and you guys have proven yourselves to be, you know, a well-oiled machine, getting some really awesome creative work out, but, you know, working to a schedule and deadlines, and everyone at Pride is super excited and happy with what we've done.